are here to talk about the saddle stitch. You've seen a number of videos and there are different issues with regard to different videos, and I'm going to try and cover all the different issues in one video and put it all in one place. We're going to look at what the saddle stitch is. And to be fair, we can actually look at that now. A saddle stitch is basically a running stitch, or two running stitches, one front and one back. Whereas a locking stitch has the thread from the front going through, locking round another thread and back through the hole again. So if one thread fails, both stitches go. Whereas with a running stitch, it goes in, out, in, out, in, out, and does that both sides. And then we have the saddle stitch. We're going to look at making our holes with a pricking iron. I'm going to use a number 8 Joseph Dixon pricking iron, inch and a half. I've also got an inch as well for going around the corner, so we'll have a look at that. We'll have a look at stitching with the right hand and left hand priority, left hand, right hand priority. So we'll look at doing that. We'll stitch around the corner and have a look at it, and we'll see what happens when we put the pricking iron around a corner with and without a hole, and you can make your mind up over which one you like the best. So that gives you a very basic rundown of what we're going to do. But first and foremost, we're going to have a look at the pricking iron and how hard we're going to smack it, where and why. Let's have a look at first making the holes with the pricking iron. I'm going to use a set of dividers. The reason being is there's a very fine point on these, and the line that you want down the edge of the leather needs to be as thin as possible. What we're going to do then is lay the pricking iron over the top of the line. And the idea is to put the line between the holes and hit it. We're not going to hit it hard. We don't want to go through the leather all the way. Hard enough to mark. Some people are struggling with going around a corner with a pricking iron. So let's have a look at an option that might assist you. Let's just use a set of dividers to go around our corner. Then I'm going to take a scratch awl, put it where the two lines meet, and make a little round hole. Nothing too big. Then, straddling the line, gonna make sure we've got the distance from the hole to the first prong absolutely right. It says absolutely right. I'll hit it and it won't be, but we'll see. And then we'll turn it and we'll do the other side. So we've made two sets of holes down either side with a round hole meeting that's going to act hopefully as a hinge for our thread. The needles that I refer to are the John James number 2 harness needles. And if I ask for those over here, what I will get is a 55mm long 1.02 diameter needle, which is this one. It seems if you ask for the number 2 in the States, you will actually get what's sold over here as a number 17. And that's 60mm long and 1.42mm in diameter, a mil and a half almost, which is considerably larger than the needles that I'm describing, and people are having difficulty. And you can see, if I put them together, the difference between the two needles is quite distinct. Now we've got to the hole. What I don't want to do is go through the hole with the awl, because it's round, I want to keep it round. I don't want to give it an angle by putting the awl through it. So just to make my life easier, I'm going to go through it from the front. In fact, fact, it was quite a lot easier to go through than expected. So I'll carry on. Stitching left-handed but right-hand priority. That'll do for a minute. So let's have a look at it. Now what we have here is a nice corner. That's quite smart. All right, we're going to have a look at the saddle stitch a slightly different way. Now, a lot of people are asking about this little knot that I stick in and why. And what we're going to do is look at the saddle stitch in its most basic form, going back to a very, very crude way of looking at it. And what we've got here is a row of holes, and this is representative of some people drilling holes in leather because they're having difficulty making it with the awl. So I'm going to use this to highlight a point. Now what I've got here is a couple of huge needles and some 1.4mm bonded polyester tiger thread. So it's big and chunky, but it should emphasise the point. I'm going to do this right-handed in case anybody is struggling with that. And like I normally would, I'm going to centre the thread. Now what we would do is stitch with a row of angled holes, but we're not going to, we're going to go round and we're going to look at why the saddle stitch does what it does. So the first needle makes no odds whatsoever, the hole is empty, it's going to go in. It doesn't matter at this time if we put the needle on top or underneath because there's no angle to the hole. So I shall stick it underneath for the sake of argument and then put it back through. Now what we've got here is two threads going through the same hole from the same direction. They're coming from this direction forward. And because they're going through the same hole, they're going to pass each other. We've got no choice in the matter. One will sit over the top of the other, and that will begin to influence what happens on the face of the leather. So we'll carry on, and for continuity, I'm sticking my needle at the back underneath. So the second needle is underneath the first needle, and I'm trying to put it through the same side of the thread each time. So we've got four stitches there. And we've got, in essence, a saddle stitch, but there's no angle to it. There's no aesthetic look to the whole thing. Now, sometimes when you're making very, very thin articles, this will happen, because the transference of the threads inside the hole hasn't got enough space within the leather to be able to sit properly, and it doesn't sit nicely. So that's one of the occasions where I shall do one of the passes with the thread, and I'll do exactly the same, but this time with a couple of stitches, I shall pass the thread over the needle. So first needle goes in, second needle underneath, comes back through, but on this occasion, I shall pass that thread over, and that's creating what is in essence an overhand knot. And an overhand knot is just basic where it's two threads tied one over the other and pulled. It's the start of the knot of the tying your shoes. Now all of a sudden we can see, because we've adjusted the priority of the thread and that knot, it's forcing this thread inside this loop to the top, and that's creating an angle. So we shall do exactly the same again. So first needle goes through, second needle underneath, it comes back, and then we'll pass that thread, creating that overhand knot, and we can see there this knot beginning to appear on the front. Same thing's happening on the back. And as we give that some tension, we're forcing that to the top of the hole, even though the hole is round. And we'll continue a couple. And we can see the stitch now beginning to lay because of that knot. Now, people are saying that the knot adds strength. It doesn't, not at all. The only thing that's going to add more strength to this is a thicker thread, because all these are individual lengths. you have two lengths running at the front and the back. And that is as strong as it's ever going to get. So the knot isn't going to add anything. What it will do is lay the stitches at the angle that you want. But if you're stitching multiple layers together that aren't glued, so if I've got four or five layers of this leather, putting that little knot in adds a little bit more tension. It holds the thread, because sometimes you'll notice when you're stitching, particularly veg tan, which gives a lot, you'll pull nice and tight, and as you relax, it relaxes and the thread undoes slightly. Putting that knot on keeps the tension. It holds the leather together smarter whilst you're stitching it. Once it's stitched, it's stitched. That knot's going to add no more strength whatsoever. But that's just to give you an idea of the two reasons why I put that small overhand knot on. Sometimes if the leather's not quite right, or if I'm using a particularly difficult thread, or if I want a really small hole, or any number of things, I'll put that in. Sometimes I do it just because I want to stitch a different way. There are so many different ways of stitching, it's just a different way of looking. Just to look at the back, we can see that the normal line of stitching where we started is very flat, and it's not sitting very even. Just applying that knot at the front has laid the stitching at the back as well. All right, so let's have a look at the saddle stitch right hand. The face that I'm stitching on is facing my right hand. I'm sitting at the end of it, and the holes are pointing down and towards me. Now, I'm going to start off my row of stitching by centering up my thread. I'm going to use white thread on this because it's black bridle. I'm going through the scrap bin and finding all the bits and pieces that I can, so hopefully it should highlight it quite nicely. So I'm going to stitch from the right. Now I'm going to make the hole with the awl, and then I'm going to use the right hand needle and use that first. Left hand needle, second needle, because the holes are pointing down and towards me, I'm going to go underneath. So number two goes under number one, turns round and back, and then goes through the bottom of the hole and towards me. And then we'll take the tension up there. And we can see already that first stitch is sat at an angle. And the hole's doing that for us. We don't need to worry about putting any knot or twist. And it is going to come through. I will fight it. I'm obviously weakened by this man flu. Here we are. And we're building up already a line of stitching. So it begins to look nice. And we can see our stitching looking quite smart already. So that stitching with the awl in the right hand and the first needle through the leather is also from the right hand. So we're keeping the consistency of making sure that the second needle in our left hand is underneath. Now, to stitch from the back, very little changes apart from which needle goes through first. The awl goes in, the needle finds the awl blade, follows it back through the hole. Number two needle is now our right hand needle, because the holes are pointed down towards us, it goes underneath, and at which point it turns and goes back through the hole in the bottom, and we'll carry on just like that. And you can see that, albeit we've switched which needle goes through the leather first, the stitching doesn't change. So when you see somebody stitching a slightly different way, not necessarily wrong, it is just quite simply different. If you're achieving that stitch, you're doing it right. Yeah. All right, faces stay in the same way, pointed towards the camera. I'm sitting the other side. As a result of me sitting the other side, the holes are now pointing up and towards me. So, stitching from the left, all in the left hand, left-hand needle first, because I'm stitching up and towards me. Excuse me, my right hand is going to be my second needle, and that's going to go on top. And then as that returns through the hole, it returns to the top of the hole towards me. And we begin to build up that line of stitching. That's becoming quite common now. Now this is a comfortable way of stitching. As long as you're achieving the goal, however you decide to stitch is entirely up to you. As long as you're achieving that saddle stitch. And to prove a point, once again, we'll come from the right hand side. Carry on. Now, if it's not going to take an awful lot of pressure, you can make your hole in your first hole of your line of stitching and centre your thread. And that's your first stitch. If you're going to be under some particular pressure, or if you'd like to add a back stitch, then instead of going through that hole, we will make a hole in our third hole and we'll start there. So we'll centre our thread on our third hole and then we'll set ourselves up, and what we'll do is we'll stitch away from us for two stitches. So we're going to put the awl through. Now, because we're stitching away from us, the priority of the hole is high and away, and as a result of that, our second needle wants to be on top. And when it returns, it wants to come through the top of the hole furthest away from us, from the thread, like so. And as we pull that through and give that attention, you will see that that is beginning to angle nicely the way that it should. And then we will put the awl through the last hole, exactly the same again. Second needle wants to be on top because it's stitching up and away from us. Look through the top of the hole, take up the tension, and there's our first two stitches. Now we're going to come back on ourselves, but what we don't want to do is put our awl back through the hole that's got the thread in it, because that could cut the thread, and that's just knackered basically what you've done. So what we're going to do, first hole, well, this is where it gets a little bit snug. Sometimes you need to apply a little bit of coercion with a pair of pliers. Bit of tension. Now I'm stitching right-handed, right-hand priority needle. You can do this right-handed, left-hand priority needle. And there's two back stitches, simple as that. And what we're going to do is carry on. So we're going to put first needle through, second needle's going to catch it. Now we're stitching up and away from us, so again the second needle is on top and the second needle wants to come high through that hole. And like I say, this is where it can become difficult. So we can use a pair of smooth pliers. There's no teeth in these pliers at all. If you're going to do it, tug it from the end. So you're holding it like that, so you're not going to whip it out to the side and stab something inadvertently. I mean, it might be your own leg, you never know. Just show a little bit of safety consciousness. And then we'll give that some tension. Exactly the same again, stitching up and away from us, a needle on top. Back through the hole. Force the issue with the pliers. There's two stitches, and all I'm going to do is with the front needle return it to the back, take it all the way through, snip it off, and then apply a little bit of heat. And then we have a traditional saddler's stitch, the saddle stitch. I'm not too sure if I mentioned it, I may well have done. Find me on Facebook, Armitage Leather. If you've got any thoughts and feelings, please feel free to share. Come and find my page, like it, put some comments. If you've got any questions, stick them on there. Everybody gets to see the question, everybody gets to see the answer.